ओके, तो हम आ गए हैं चैप्टर 4 पे और वी आर ऑल्सो इन द वीक 13. आई नो आई एम रनिंग लेट बाय कपल ऑफ वीक्स, 2-3 वीक्स, बट या आई ट्राई टू कैच इट अप सूनर और लेटर. सो लेट्स स्टार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर 4. श्री भगवान उवाच इमं विवस्वते योगं प्रोक्तवान अहमव्ययम् विवस्वान् मनवे प्राह मनुरिक्ष्वा कवे ब्रवीत. नेक्स्ट श्लोक. एवं परंपरा प्राप्तम् इमं राजर्षयो विदुः सकालेनेह महता योगो नष्टः परन्तप. नेक्स्ट श्लोक. स एवायं मया तेद्य योगः प्रोक्तः पुरातनः भक्तोऽसि मे सखा चेति रहस्यं ह्येतदुत्तमम्. अर्जुन उवाच अपरं भवतो जन्म परं जन्म विवस्वतः कथमे द्विजानीयां त्वमादौ प्रोक्तवानिति. So basically chapter 4 starts. How does chapter 4 starts, right? So we all know, right? I mean, any stream of knowledge, either it is in the field of art, medicine, or anything, right? I mean, it evolves over a period of time, right? It can be a science, sociology, anything, right? Now when this tradition started, right, somebody might have started, right, and then it moves from generation to generation to the current generation, which is how it is, right? So this is how Krishna says that I have started this, I gave first to certain person, he names, right, Manu, and then it got transfers and all of those things. And then he said over a period of time, right, since it is being across the generation, so sometimes the knowledge get lost, right, or it gets muddled up, right, in between. So then he says, okay, also the knowledge gets refined, but sometimes it gets muddled up also, right? And that is where if certain in certain fields, right, of art, science or something, if there is no proper experimentation, right, and if people don't use it to experience new things, the knowledge will almost get muddled, right? So that's very important that we need to have a scientific band of mind for some of the people to start off and think through how we can improve on certain things which are coming from the past, right? And then Krishna says that since you are my friend, right, I'm going to reveal you this knowledge. Okay, now Arjuna is kind of a doubtful person, right, at this point. He said, hey Krishna, you are born now, right, and you are saying that something you have already delivered in the past, right? So how it is possible, okay? So this is the question which arises in Arjuna, and then let's start off. Sri Bhagavan uvacha bahuni me vayati tani janmani tavach Arjuna tanyaham veda sarvani natvam vetha parantapa. Next shloka. अजोपि सन्यव्य आत्मा भूतानामीश्वरोपि सन प्रकृतिं स्वामधिष्ठाय संभवाम्यात्ममायया. नेक्स्ट श्लोक. यदा यदा हि धर्मस्य ग्लानिर्भवति भारत अभ्युत्थानं धर्मस्य तदात्मानं सृजाम्यहं परित्राणाय साधूना विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां धर्मसंस्थापनार्थाय संभवानि युगे युगे. सो वंस द क्वेश्चन अराइजेस इन अर्जुनास माइंड, राइट, सो देन Krishna gives an answer, right, saying that you might not know, but I know that I've been born in the past, right? and I'm kind of So I have been born in the past, right? Though I'm a soul, right? Soul, we know, right? Some of the things, right? A consciousness. I'm a consciousness, right? Which is not born and not died, right? And that is like one consciousness, or you can say it's a one big mind, right? But still, whenever there is a need to the society, right? Wherever there are certain things which is required to be done in the society, right? Then I take birth again and again to set the things right, to basically make things happen in a way it has to be happen, or set up the dharma. Okay, and that's what now he started talking about what is dharma and all of those things. Right? So let's continue. जन्म कर्म च मे दिव्यम एवं यो वेत्ति तत्वतः त्यक्त्वा देहं पुनर्जन्म नैति मामेति सोऽर्जुन. नेक्स्ट श्लोक. वीत राग भय क्रोधा मन्मया मामुपाश्रितः बहवो ज्ञान तपसा पुता मद्भावमागतः. नेक्स्ट श्लोक. ये यथा मां प्रपद्यन्ते तांस्तथैव भजाम्यहं मम वर्तमानो वर्तन्ते मनुष्यः पार्थ सर्वसः. नेक्स्ट श्लोक. कांक्षन्त कर्मणां सिद्धिं यजन्त इह देवतः क्षिप्रं हि मानुषे लोके सिद्धिर्भवति कर्मजा. ओके, सो बेसिकली नाउ देन ही टॉक्स अबाउट सम ऑफ द एक्शंस, राइट? And this actions, right, what you do, right, and when you know that whatever actions you are doing are divine, right, then you don't get into entanglement of rebirth and all of those things, right? So basically anything what you do, right, and you have no cravings, no aversions towards anyone, right, then you are in that one state of a consciousness, or one with one consciousness, right? So for that you have to drop all your cravings and aversions, right? So that is very, very important. Also at the same time, right, you need to be free from fear, anger and craving, right? Now how you can become free from angers, cravings, fear, angers and cravings, right? So first we have to ask ourselves, right, what are those cravings, right? Okay, what are you craving for, right? Similarly, you have to ask the question, right, what are you afraid of, right? What is making you fearful, right? Maybe your cravings can be only for those five senses, right? So that's max people can think about, right, when it comes to cravings, right? They can either have a food or a sex, or a smell, sight and touch, right? Similarly, what are you angry about? Right? Very, very important thing to think, right? There are only two or three things which makes you angry, right? One is the attitude of someone, right? And somebody is doing something, some actions which you don't like, right? Then you become angry, right? Similarly, it also can happen, right? Some of the appearances makes you angry, right? So that's some of the things, right? I mean, their attitude, their actions or their appearance, right? That can make you angry, right? But just think about it, right? There is a diversity in this whole universe, right? If you get angry about somebody doing a way in a certain way, which is not in alignment to you, then it seriously needs to be think about. Okay? So basically what, I mean, just coming back to our things, right? I mean, it's very important how we perceive the reality, right? Or how we manifest that consciousness, the things will happen in that way, right? So very important that when this shloka says that you, if you want to achieve something in materialistic world, the first thing it happens, it has to first build into your chitta, right? And it is more like a blueprint which you build and then you achieve in that world, right? That's how that universal laws also works, right? And that's what it is talking about. Okay. Now let's proceed to the next shloka. चातुर्यवर्ण्यं मया श्रेष्ठं गुणकर्म विभागशः तस्य कर्तारमपि मां विध्यकर्तारमव्ययम्। नेक्स्ट श्लोक। नमां कर्माणि लिम्पन्ति न मे कर्म फले स्पृहः इति मां यो भिजानाति कर्मभिर्न स बध्यते। So basically, now it's talking about, Krishna is talking about, right, the different actions, right, and he says, right, all the actions in this world can be divided into four castes, right? It can be a businessman, intellectual class, military class, or service class, right? Again, right, your actions define those classes, not your or not in which family you are born, right? And again, at the same time, once you change your actions, right, then you change your class also. Sometimes you start with a service class and then you move into business class, right? I mean, you start your own business, and sometimes it happens that you've done the business, now you wanted to go into more intellectual thought, reasonings and all of those things, right? And then you becomes into that class, right? And that's all it's all about. Okay, so I think that's all we covered the week, this week. We'll talk about more into our next week. Take care, bye-bye.